Do you recognize this song? Not yet? What if I move things around a little bit? How about now?
Dreams of living life like rappers do. Like rappers do, like rappers. Bump that new E40 at the school.
What you just heard is sampling. And sampling, generally defined as the reuse of a portion of a sound recording in another recording, is a technique that producers and songwriters have been utilizing for decades to create unique and genre-blending music. By taking a piece of a song or audio and manipulating it through various changes, like speeding up or slowing down, layering, reversing and looping, an artist can transform the sample into something entirely unique from its place of origin. Samples can form the entire basis of a song, or it can serve as a simple sound effect. There are no rules to how you can utilize them, other than copyright law, of course. In order to truly understand the beauty and artistry in musical sampling, we will be exploring the world of samples through songs across genres, decades, and mediums. The conception of the idea of sampling can be traced back to a musical genre called musique concrète, which involved experimental artists recording different sounds to tape decks, and then physically cutting and resplicing the tapes together. As technology evolved, musicians continued to find new applications for this technique, such as the use of different clocks and casino machines throughout Pink Floyd's Dark Side of the Moon. One of the beauties of sampling is that it generally does not require the knowledge or instruments necessary to typically record music, and this is one of the big reasons why it became the go-to technique and backbone for the emerging genre of hip-hop during the 1980s. DJs and music producers familiar with turntables would loop sections of a song and then have MCs rap over them at live concerts. However, this method would be largely replaced as new equipment like the Akai MPC, designed with the exclusive purpose of sampling other sounds, hit the market in the late 80s. These machines changed the game entirely and allowed what seemed like infinite possibilities for sampling. Many producers favored sampling soul, R&B, and funk records to create their beats, oftentimes looping one continuous section of music for an entire song. Sampling wasn't and never has been exclusive to the genre of hip-hop. Some of the most legendary pop songs of all time, like Toxic by Britney Spears, were also built on samples.
Can't you see? I'm calling.
It's important to note that sampling wasn't a solely American technique either, as international artists like Daft Punk use sampling techniques like chopping to create unforgettable dance tracks like One More Time. Sampling is not exclusive to specific genres, but it's also not exclusive to specific mediums. TV shows are also known for using sampling to create their soundtracks and theme songs. Contrary to the many musical styles that have came and went, sampling has never quite gone out of favor. In fact, it is still used as the basis for many modern songs across many genres, including hip-hop, dance music, and pop. Ooh. I believe sampling will never go out of style, because it has an ability like no other to create wholly unique and intriguing musical landscapes. As the equipment and software used to sample becomes increasingly cheaper and user-friendly, I predict we will see a large increase in sampling across all genres in the years to come. There is much more related to sampling, like copyright law and interpolation, that I did not cover today. If you like this video and want to learn more about the things I left out, comment below and I may make a separate video on these topics in the future. Thank you all for watching, and I truly hope you learned something and appreciate the beauty of music, and all art, a little bit more.